This is a video from everystepcalculus.com demonstrating how my programs work on a TI-89 titanium calculator and other calculators in the TI system for physics and calculus problems. This is a problem on average rate of change in calculus, problem that comes up in tests and professors talking about it. So let's get started. In my programs, you have to push second alpha to put in INDEX, and then press alpha to put the 8 in the open close parentheses. Press enter and you're into my menu. The first one is average rate of change because it's got the A in it, alphabetically. We're going to scroll to that. Press enter. This is the problem that might be on a test. I gave you some sort of definition. Average rate of change, the amount of change in one item divided by the corresponding amount of change in another. We're going to enter the function. We'll enter the one up here, a little bit more elaborate. Let's go, you have to press alpha before you enter anything into my entry lines here. Let's go 3 times x squared plus 6 times x minus 16. I always show you what you've entered so you can change it in case you made a mistake. We'll say it's okay. And you have to have a range, so we're going to give the range of A or B. Lower range, let's go alpha 8. And the upper range, let's go alpha 11. Again, I show you what you've entered. Here's the formula for it. F of x sub 2 minus f of x sub 1 divided by x 2 minus x 1. I put the variables in here for you, so you write this on your paper. This is what you'd write on your test paper or homework right away. Don't even think about it. Just do whatever comes up on these screens. You notice I'm substituting 11 for all the x's in this function. Comes up with 413. That's 11, the upper range. Here's the lower range, 8. Substituting 8 for everything. You write this all on your paper. Here comes the answers. Now we plug it into the formula, and the average rate of change is 63. Okay, what does this mean? This is the slope of a line, 63 over 1, rise over run. You go up 63 points on the y-axis, go over 1 on the x-axis, draw a line from that through the origin of the graph, and that's what you found, the slope of a line. Congratulations. Pretty neat, huh? Every step. Calculus.com. Go to my site, buy my programs, and pass calculus.